be the clothespin. I'll be the line. We'll hang out together. Won't that be fine? You can be the dustpan. I'll be the broom. We'll sweep together all over the room. You be my dishpan. I'll be your dish. We'll swim together like two little fish. You can be the window. I'll be the window shade. That's the porter's love song to the chambermaid.
Would you and your little sweetie move over so we can all sit together?
What?
I said, would you and your little sweetie move over so we can all sit together?
What?
Thanks very much, sir. It's real nice of you.
Yeah?
You can be my...
Give us a beer, huh? All of us.
Pulling line. We'll pull together. Won't that be fine? You can be my oil mop, but I'll be the oil. We'll mingle together.
Those kids are too young. Get them out of here.
You be my washboard.
Look, can't serve you, kid. You better clear on out of here.
Too young? Look, I'm 23 years old. All these kids are. Those girls, they're married. The one on the end with the baby face? He's got two kids right home right now with a babysitter. Oh, look here, I got legal proof. 23, like it says. Look, I'm paying cash and buying.
How about you?
Huh?
How about you?
For me?
Yeah. Don't you guys get mixed up having the same name?
No, we're brothers, all of us are. We all got the same name. See, my old man, he was a real smart guy, and he figured he'd name all his kids the same. So when he wants one of us, all he gotta do is remember one name. It's real simple. Everybody ought to do it.
Okay, wise boy, that's enough. Now go on, get out of here.
Come on, fella, say.
Look, will you give us a break, fella?
Look, I want it quiet in here when I'm talking. Look, we're customers. I ordered seven beers. Now, there's some money. Now, serve us. Hey, this is really a dead joint. What's wrong with the music? Well, say, Fatso!
Hold a minute. Hold on. I'm
gonna... Hey, wait a minute. We're kidding you. Can't you relax? We're kidding you. Is that right, fellas? What's the matter?
Yeah, we're just humor.
Look, we're leaving. We don't want to drink anyway. We're going. Watch us. Hey, watch us when we're leaving. See, I really mean it.
The story you are about to see is about violence and immorality, teenage violence and immorality. Children trapped in the half-world between adolescence and maturity. Their struggle to understand their need to be understood. Perhaps in his rapid progression into the material world, man has forgotten the spiritual values which are the moral fiber of a great nation. Decency, respect, fair play. Perhaps he has forgotten to teach these values to his own. He has forgotten to teach his children their responsibility before God and society. The answer may lie in the story of the delinquents, in their violent attempt to find a place in society. This film is a cry to a busy world, a protest, a reminder to those who must set the example.
You can be the driver, I'll be the driver.
Hey, how'd you like that man, huh? I bet that window cost him $250. That'll show him, huh? And what do you say we go back and bust the other one? Why don't we just walk in and order another beer?
Yeah, you did great.
Did you ever see anybody as scared as a dizzy broad?
Hey, you guys, where are we going?
Huh? Let's go back and bust the other one.
Hey, maybe I can get a job. How do I sound?
Come on, you guys, what are we going to do?
Hey, how about the drive-in? Why don't we go to the drive-in, Charlie?
Movies, what's the matter with you? I'll tell you what, why don't we go to a debating contest? Movies, what's the matter with him?
That's a good idea. Okay, we'll go to the movie.
Oh, what's planned?
Well, who cares what's planned? Who's going to watch the show? Let's go, Jay boy. The cinema.
Okay, here we go.
Well, I wish you could have seen that. I know what these kids are coming to. Did you hear it? Criminal, that's what it is. There must have been 12 youngsters in that car piled up all over it, going up and down in the middle of the night. They cut right across our lawn. They're much too young to even drive. I've told you time and time again, I don't want Scotty to drive the car at night. Much too young. These kids today have no sense of responsibility, none at all.
Well, don't worry about it. Every time some kid does something wrong, you want to send everybody under 18 to reform school.
Shh, we're trying to watch a show.
Scotty's all right. Don't worry about it.
Now look, Charles, I tell you, this is nothing you can brush off. This is a real serious thing. I forbid you to let Scotty drive the car at night. Are you going to tell him, or am I going to have to? Well, I wish you could have seen what your father and I just saw. A whole carload of those crazy kids came by here doing about 90 miles an hour. They turned right around into the middle of the street and even cut across the lawn. Now, Scotty, if you're ever out with anyone like that and they're driving that this way, I just want you to get right out of the car. Now, promise me you'll do that.
Well, sure,
Mom. You have kids of your own someday. And I hope they treat you just like you treat us. Understand what your father and I go through. Sissy, those dishes have been piled up in that kitchen for over an hour. Come on, right now, come on.
All right, I'm coming.
Sissy, come on, baby.
Okay. Can't even watch a TV show around here anymore.
Come on, baby.
Scotty, I wish you'd tell those friends of yours not to drive like that around the house here. You know how it gets your mother upset.
They're not friends of mine, Dad. I don't even know who they were.
Well, just a friendly tip, that's all. You know how your mother worries about you kids. It's nothing. Forget it.
Hey, Dad. I was going to take Janice to the drive-in tonight. Think I might have the car?
That's what I was trying to tell you. No trouble at all until those crazy kids came driving up here on the lawn, scaring your mother half out of her wits. Sure, you know you can use a car anytime I'm not using it. Just means I've got another argument to go through with your mother, that's all. You think you kids would get smart. You make it tough on yourselves. Here. You just tell those guys to take it easy around here, will you?
Sure. Thanks,
man. Hey. You're seeing quite a bit of this Janice, aren't you, boy?
No, I'm just taking it to show, that's all.
Yeah, I know. Every night.
I'll see you later, Dad.
Okay, buddy. Believe me,
I've learned something new about the game. Daddy, come here a minute. I got something for you.
Yeah? Yeah, come on. What do you want? I'm late.
Going out with Jess tonight?
Come on. What do you want?
You like her a lot, don't you?
No, stupid. I take her out every night because she makes me sick.
Do you love her?
Oh, go on in and do your dishes.
Well, you go steady with her, don't you?
What are you asking so many silly questions for? All right, I go steady with her. So what?
Well, here. Give her this. You tell her it's a present from your sister.
Hey,
Dan?
Got him up here.
Hi, honey, aren't you ready yet? Come on, we're going to be late.
I can't go, Scotty.
Scotty, come in here a minute, will you, please?
Hello, Scotty.
Hello, Mrs. Wilson. Is something wrong, sir?
This has nothing to do with you.
You know how old Janice is?
Oh, yes, sir. She's 17.
She's 16 years old. She won't be 17 for 5 months. She just finished her junior year in high school. She's a child. And she's carrying on with you like a woman 25 years old. And we're just not going to have that, Scotty. She's too young, and for that matter, so are you.
I don't understand, sir. We haven't done anything wrong.
Scotty, it has nothing to do with you personally. We think you're a very nice
boy. It's just going steady business. This talk about being engaged. She's only 16.
Daddy, leave him alone. Why can't you leave him alone?
Janice, we don't want to do anything to hurt you or Scotty. But we're your parents. Believe me, this is the best thing. Now, please. You're going steady. That means you don't see any other boys. You don't get a chance to meet any other boys. It's just like being engaged, and you know it. You got a hope chest, and everything you put in it is something you hope Scotty will like. You wear his class ring on a chain around your neck. You keep his picture beside your bed. You write each other notes. I've seen them. You talk about how many children you're going to have, what you're going to name them. Why, you talk about things your mother and I have never discussed. And you tell me that's not serious? I don't say there's anything wrong with these things by themselves, but you're kids, both of you, you're kids. You're not being fair to yourselves. I don't want you to see Janice anymore.
But Daddy!
Can't I see her once a week or maybe on a special
No, not at all.
Please!
You're going away to college in the fall, aren't you?
Yes, sir, I'm going up to the university.
Well, come back for Christmas vacation, you still want to see Janice, why, you come by, and we'll talk about it.
But, Daddy, that's all summer, and that's 6 months.
Oh, baby, it'll be all right. Well, you can still go out with other boys. And, well, then, this Christmas, when Scotty gets home, we'll have a party for him here.
Oh, leave me alone.
Good night, Scotty.
Good night, Scotty.
You want a beer, Charlie?
Yeah.
Hey, what are you doing?
Open us a beer, will you?
Why don't you guys shut up and watch the movie, will you?
Is that all you think of as movies?
Come on, cut it out. Aaron, stop bothering me.
Another one.
Come on, turn out the lights, will you?
Jeez, I've never seen a guy in my life so crazy for the movies.
Good luck.
Charlie, look.
What?
Look, Charlie.
What?
Isn't that the guy's car we had the beef with last week? The one who smarted off the Meg?
Where, which one?
Now, we're right in front of us, see? The brown one.
Yeah, yeah. That's the guy.
Hey, what do? We fix him, huh?
Wait a minute, let me think.
Should we take him? Come on, it's the guy. Let's take him, Charlie.
Wait a minute. Just cut their tires. Take the left rear one, then get back here and don't let them see you. This ought to be fun. Yeah.
Hey, look at this stupid guy. He ain't even got the song box in his car. He's watching the movie and ain't even listening.
You guys go around the front and we'll take them from this side.
Leg, you run right over it.
Are you crazy? I didn't hear nothing. Charlie, you missed it. We run right over this guy's leg, busted it good. I tell you, I heard it.
Man, those guys didn't know what they were getting into.
Yeah, it's the last time I'm going to the movies with you guys. I haven't seen a show all the way through in the last 10 pictures I tried to see.
Well, next time we get a guy with buck teeth, you take him, huh?
All right, shut up. Anybody get hurt?
Yeah, I bruised my drinking hand.
You're kind of in a spot there, fellow. What started it?
What started it? You know what?
Will you shut up?
What's the matter with you? You know,
look. I'd like to talk to this guy and find out why those guys had it in for him. You know, I don't mind helping a guy out of a spot, but I'd like to know why. Get it? Don't shy yourself.
Scotty, wait.
Eddie?
Jay?
Hi.
Chizzy? Steve?
Hi.
Yeah, what those guys have it in for you for, kid? They were mad.
I don't know. I never saw them before in my life.
Maybe they just didn't like the way you look.
You mean that? You mean you never saw those guys before?
No, never.
Maybe they mistook you for somebody else.
Yeah, I bet that was it. They thought you were somebody else.
Oh, how long are we going to stand around here yakking? Come on, honey. Let's go. Let's go dancing, huh?
Hey, look at that old joint. Way back there. Is that a house? Where? I don't see nothing.
Yeah, way up the road. It's a house.
Yeah. What a place for a ball. I wonder if anyone lives there.
Anybody live way out here, it'd have to be crazy.
Yeah. Hey, Charlie, come and take a look at this joint we just spun. Looks like it's empty. What a place for a ball, man. Let's go check it.
Go check it.
What do you need me for? What about Junior here? You want to go with us, or are you the kind of get scared in the dark?
You know, you talk and talk, and someday you're going to talk so much you're going to find all your teeth right down your throat. I think this is the guy who can just handle you, Eddie.
Oh, this I'd like to see.
Look, I got no beef with you guys. You helped me out of a jam.
Come on now.
Come on.
Let's go look this dump over.
Yeah.
Don't pay any attention to him. He's nervous all the time. He's like that.
Well, this must be my night, huh? First the guys at the drive-in, now your buddy.
What were you doing in the drive-in by yourself anyway? Don't tell me you like movies that well.
No. No, I had a fight with my girl. Well, not exactly with my girl, with her dad. I didn't know what else to do, I guess, so I went to the drive-in.
Your girl's dad? What's he trying to do, make you marry her?
No. No, it's nothing like that. But you know how some kids' folks are. Well, anyway, he found out we were going steady and said we couldn't go out anymore. Just like that. Boom. How stupid can you get?
How old is she, 12?
That's the whole point. She's 17.
And her old man won't have any dates.
Well, yeah, she can have dates, all right, but just not with me, which makes everything just great.
Well, look, you got no problem. All you do is get some friend of hers, of yours, let's say, and he goes by and he picks her up and brings her to meet you. It's simple.
I don't see any point in trying to sneak around about it.
Look, you like the girl, don't you?
Well, sure.
Well, don't be silly about it. I'll tell you what. You get a hold of her tomorrow morning, and you tell her to tell her old man that she's got a date tomorrow night with me. Bill charges. Tell him we're going to the movies. Then I'll go by, and I'll pick her up, and I'll bring her to meet you. It's simple.
Look, I don't want to put you to any trouble. Besides, if anybody owes anybody a favor around here, I owe you one.
Look, I like you. You're a nice guy. You could have ripped my friend Eddie apart there a few minutes ago. So don't worry about it. Tell you what, you fix it up so I pick her up tomorrow night at 8. You meet me at 7:30. Let's say, 68 Nudgeville. Then I'll meet you there tomorrow night on a corner at 7:30, okay? Okay, come on. You know, Eddie got his feelings hurt. I think you better go, really.
Okay.
Tomorrow night, huh?
Hey, look, Charlie, I'm sorry about it.
Look, forget it. You better go, really. Tomorrow night, huh?
Okay. Trying to do that. I just see him trying to get some sleep. Go on, get out of here.
Did you lose?
You can get out of here, or I have to throw you out.
Can't even ask a civilized question around here.
Hey, sissy. Come here a minute. I want to talk to you.
Are you in a fight?
Yeah, look, never mind that. Can I trust you on something? I mean, really trust you?
Sure. I never told Mom and Dad about that pipe you had, and I was only 5.
Okay, now look, this is important. You know where Jan lives.
Sure. Did you give it to her?
I give what to her?
My present.
Oh, no. No, I didn't have a chance to, but I'll give it to her tonight. Now look, I want you to go down and play around the house. Don't go up to the door. Because I don't want her mother or her father to see you, but just play around there until she comes out. And then I want you to tell her, but wait until she gets away from the house. I want you to tell her that it's important that I see her and that she should meet me in the park. She'll know where that is.
Are you going to elope?
Oh, come on, stupid. This is serious. Just tell her that I've got to see her and I'll wait all day if I have to. And don't tell anybody about this. Do you understand?
I won't tell anybody, honest.
Okay, now go on out of here and let me get dressed, huh?
Did you lose?
No, I won. Now go on, get out of here.
bacon?
Well, sure, honey. What is it?
Come here, I want to whisper. Ask us, I'm showing this to you. Scotty wants to see you right away. He's waiting for you at the park, but don't tell nobody, because he was in a terrible fight, but he was. It's very important, so don't tell anybody.
What happened? Is he all right?
I can't talk now, because they're watching, but it's very important, so don't tell anybody. But he's waiting for you at the park.
Well, nothing. Forget about the presents.
Hi.
Hi. Are you all right? Sissy said you were hurt.
Look, Shep. Come on, honey. Let's go over here where we can talk a little bit.
Let me look at you.
Oh, Sissy makes a big deal out of everything. Come on.
But tell me what happened.
Well, let's get away from the steps. What's the scoop on your dad last night? Boy, I never saw him so mad. I didn't know what to say to him. What happened anyway? What made him so mad?
You wouldn't even talk about it anymore.
Well, why?
He just thinks we're too young to be so serious.
Why? What? Oh, come on, stupid.
I'm afraid he means it, though. What are we going to do?
Well, how should I know? I promise you in a week or so I'll go over and I'll talk to him, but gee, in the meantime, I still would like to see you.
Do you know what Daddy said?
Hey, honey, last night I met a guy. His name was Bill Charters. He's a real nice guy. You'd like him, Jan, really.
Well, what does he have to do with this?
Well, you could just tell your folks that you had a date with Bill. Just say you're going to movies or something, and, well, you could come over to the house and pick you up.
But my folks don't know who would I say he is.
Well, I'd just say you met him at school. Say anything. I don't know. You could come over, pick you up about 8 o'clock, and I could meet you, and we could go out. Later on, Charlie could drive you home. Come on, it'll be all right, honey. Come on. Please? Pretty please?
You're such a little boy. But you always know how to get to me.
That's because I love you.
I tell you, this guy's a real creep. We should let those guys in the drive and take care of him, Charlie. We'd have box seats. Look, what's this guy to you anyway? First time we get any action, he's gonna run right home to his mama. You watch. He's chicken.
Eddie, you got a warped personality, you know that? You gotta like people, or people ain't gonna like you.
How long we gotta sit around here waiting?
No matter where we are, you wanna be someplace else.
Here comes Golden Boy now.
Hi. Sorry I'm late.
Forget it. We like standing here in the street corner. Gives us a chance to think.
All right, come on. You all hop in Scotty's car while I go pick up his girl.
Oh,
wait. Watch the car, will you? Oh. Where's she live?
Oh, it's just the next block over, 815.
You wait here. I'll be right back.
All right.
Oh, what's her name?
Oh, Jan Wilson. And look, I wouldn't try to get into any discussions with her old man. He's awful sharp.
You know it, man.
See ya. Look, Eddie, I'm sorry about
that. Yeah, I'm sorry, too.
I have some brawl last night, huh?
Wait till tonight, though, man. Wait till tonight.
Dream Boy ain't going with us tonight. Might be a little rough for him. I hear they're gonna serve.
Look, will you get off my back? Why, what's going on tonight?
Ball, man. We're having a ball.
You remember that old house we spotted last night?
Yeah.
It was empty. We are gonna throw a party. Chibi's gonna get a record player and a whole flock of records. It's real private.
Yeah, this place ain't gonna close.
What do you mean? You're gonna break in?
No. No, we call the owners. They sent us out a key by special messenger. The guy was real nice. Says he's even gonna serve the drinks. You gonna join us, Dream Boy?
I'm afraid Jan and I won't be able to make it tonight.
Well, this night ain't gonna be so bad after all.
No, no, thanks, sir. I don't smoke. Not that I have anything against it. I just never got started. Well, I'm sure glad I'm going out with Janice tonight. I bet I've been asking her for every week for a whole... Well, ever since Christmas.
Where are you kids going tonight?
Well, we're going to take in a show. Then we're going to meet my folks afterwards with something to eat. I've been telling them so much about Janice, they want to know what she's like. You know how folks are. Here I am, graduated and everything, and they still want to know who I'm going out with.
Well, I don't know what's keeping Janice.
Oh, that's all right, Mrs. Wilson. You know how girls are. Besides, after working all day, it's kind of nice just to sit here and catch my breath.
Where do you work, Bill?
Well, it's not really much of a job, I guess. I'm not so much interested in money right now as I am in getting a good start in life. I work for the stock exchange. You know, putting the numbers up on the boards and everything. And, well, it's a real good experience, and everybody's real nice. Well, you know, after standing 8 hours on your feet all day, it's awful nice to be able to sit. Of course, that's what I'm interested in. I plan to go in stocks and bonds. Gee, hello, Janice. Sure looked nice tonight.
Hi, Bill. I hope I didn't keep you waiting.
Oh, no, I've been having a nice talk with your mother and father. Well, it's certainly nice meeting you, Mrs. Wilson. And you too, sir. Hope to see you again.
Nice meeting you, Bill. You come back.
Yes, please do. We'd love to see you again.
Well, that'll sort of be up to Janice.
Good night, Mom, Dad.
Good night, dear.
Well, good night. I'll get her in early.
You kids have a good time.
How'd I do, huh? Really had him snowed.
Where's Scotty?
You know that stockbroker bit almost floored me, too?
Please, who are you supposed to meet Scotty?
Right around the corner, honey. Right around the corner.
How'd it go?
Should have seen me, Scotty. You had an old man ready to take me in the family. I don't think you handle him right.
I probably don't.
Well, there's your sweetie, Scotty. Delivered in fine shape. Right, honey?
See, Charlie, I don't know how to thank you. You sure did me a favor.
I enjoyed it, believe me. I enjoyed it.
Come on, let's get going, huh?
Did you explain the signals to Scotty and everything?
He don't want to go. He says he got something else to do.
Gotta go, man. This is your party as much as it is ours.
I don't think tonight, Charlie, really. We'd just soon be alone for a while.
Look, I have to take you home. You gotta stick with us. Come on, it's gonna be a nice party.
Well, okay. All right.
You remember where the place was, the house we found last night?
Yeah.
Well, it's all set. When you get on the road where the house is, just stop your car, blink your headlights 3 times, then come on.
Okay.
We don't want anybody to come that wasn't invited.
Oh.
We'll see you there, huh?
Okay. Come on.
Where'd you meet him, Scotty? I don't like him.
Oh, honey, don't be silly. He's a nice guy. If it wasn't for him, we wouldn't even be here tonight. But come on, let's go.
Where are we going?
Well, to the party.
What's this party you were talking about? Flashing the lights and all that. I thought we were going to be alone tonight.
Well, honey, I thought so too, but we have to go. Maybe it won't be as bad as you think. It might even be kind of fun. Come on.
Hey, whose party is it?
Well, one of these guys' folks owns a house or something, and they're going to let us use it for a party. Don't be such a party poop. Come on.
Well, it doesn't sound right to me. Scotty, I'm afraid of that guy.
Of Charlie?
Yeah, Charlie.
Well, don't be silly, honey. If you only knew what this guy has done for me.
Just what has he done for you?
Come on, let's go. I'll tell you on the way there.
We're getting a crowd tonight. But, baby, I don't mind this guard duty at all.
Leave your keys in the car. Never can tell. We might want to leave in a hurry.
Scotty, do we have to go in?
Well, let's just go in for a little while. If we don't like it, we can always leave, okay?
Where you guys been? We've been here for almost an hour. We thought you weren't coming.
What took you so long?
You're missing all the fun.
Right, Charlie. We had a little trouble finding the place.
Yeah, a little bit.
Here's my little date for tonight. Come on, Speedy, I'll get you a drink. Hey, Eddie.
Yeah.
Here's a beer.
Yeah.
Thanks.
No, no, can I have a Coke?
A Coke? What is this, a tea party?
Give the lady a Coke. Don't make it wander to keep the kid busy. I'm the one the old man approves of.
Hey, you're just the guy I was looking for. Now that you've been in my crazy.
You are, honey.
I think we're getting scared.
Hey, look, will you excuse me a minute? I don't want to dance with a girl, Dean.
Hey, Scotty, look, I'm sorry about the other night. You know, I'm a real sore head. No hard feelings, huh? No, okay?
Sure.
Come on, I want to show you something.
Oh, come on.
I got something for you. No hard feelings, eh?
No, thanks. I got a beer.
Good. Use it for a chaser. Get us some more beer.
Please, Bill, where's Scotty? I don't feel very well.
Okay, we'll find him.
Hey, Eddie.
Yeah, Scotty?
Huh?
Is Scotty?
No, man, I thought he was with you.
Well, take care of Janice for me, will you, Eddie? Don't worry, I'll find him. I'll be right back.
I'll find him for you.
Come on, doll. Let's dance.
Honey, don't you drink?
No, thanks.
Okay, okay, okay. Just one drink to show her pal,
and then I'll let you go.
She wasn't feeling well, said she was gonna go home. Look out! Now, will you pull over?
Look, honey, I'm sorry. I'm sorry I got you into the whole mess. Jan, I said I was sorry. What else do you want me to do? Look, will you quit acting like such a spoiled child? Look, as soon as you got done dancing with Charlie, I was going to take you home, believe me.
I don't think you're man enough to leave. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say that. I was all excited.
Don't be sorry. You're right. I guess I didn't act like much of a man.
Oh, you did too, and you know it. I didn't mean to say that. We better get out of the middle of the road before someone hits us.
I think I better take you home.
No, I don't want to go home yet. Let's just drive around or something.
I don't know.
Something?
With all this whiskey in my head, that's about all I'd need would be a malt.
Oh, I'd like one. Please?
Okay.
Don't have to be so happy about it.
You caused enough trouble around here tonight. Turn off those headlights before somebody sees them. Come on, come on. Cops, cops!
Carl, better cut those lights. It looks like there's a whole mess of them here.
Car 201 to headquarters.
Come in, 201.
We're at the old Johnson house out on River Road. We have a teenage party out here, about 25 or 30. They're sending me two cars to help us and also sending a wagon.
You sure you need two cars?
Yes, we'll have to have two cars at least.
Okay, stand by.
Here we are, right back where we started from. So what happens now?
Who cares what happens now? Don't be such a worry wart.
Come on, honey, don't tickle me. That whiskey makes me so dizzy.
Oh, you're dizzy, period.
Come on. Hey, look out, your dad's gonna hear. Shh.
Oh, you have to be quiet. There might be spies around. Come on.
You We have to act like real common criminals.
Shh. Now, peek around, see if anyone's looking.
Look, there's no...
Peek around.
Oh, hey, it's lucky I did. There are two men down there. They're about 8 feet tall, and they got big black hats, and their collars are pulled up over the face right in front of your house.
Oh, they don't even count. Peek again.
Hey, a thought. We better move to the next tree, because I think this one has got a microphone in it.
Good idea. You go first. I'll follow you, Sherlock.
Okay. Run, Ryan.
Oh, I don't care.
Okay, so far so good. What happens now?
I'll peek again.
Come on. Come on. Come on. Oh, you big chicken.
Why can't they just let us alone?
They'll learn. We just have to be patient.
So nice out, and the breeze is so nice. I don't want you to go in, honey.
Oh, I don't want to go in either. But if everyone got out again, we have to go. You meet me at the park tomorrow?
Sure.
You're
gonna rip the shirt, will you, Ma?
Here, you. What did I do to get you?
Steve, wait a minute. I
want
to talk to you.
Come on,
will you?
I'll handle by myself.
Wow. Steve.
Look, Eddie. I'm
look,
sorry.
Don't say a word. I'm gonna do you a favor. Now, the cops gave the signals, right? Three blinks of the lights. Right?
Yeah, that's right.
That means somebody had to tip them off, right?
Right.
Okay. Now, you stick to that story, you hear? You go home and get some sleep, and you stick to that story. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Thanks, Eddie.
That's okay, man.
What do you want from me? They never told me this would happen.
Wait till I get you.
What do you say, Chase?
Hey, Eddie.
I don't care. They're crummy cops. I should have spit right in their face.
Yeah, I've been real smart.
Charlie, I want to talk to you.
1 minute, Pop. See you later. Look, how come the cops found that place, and how come Steve wasn't watching?
Steve, I just talked to him a few minutes ago, man. He said the cops gave the signals. Three blinks of the light, just like everyone else. He figures it was that cute boy of yours coming back, and it's the cops. So how do you think they found out?
He says they did give the signals?
Sure, you know, Steve, he wouldn't goof up on us. Look, I tell you, it was that Scotty and that crazy dame he was with. They get there late, and they leave early. And they're the only ones that don't get caught. So how do you think they found out?
We'll just fix that Mr. Scotty tomorrow. Huh? You get the guys together and you pick me up tomorrow morning at 9. Okay?
Now you're talking, Charlie. Now you're talking.
You better listen to me, young lady. Because when I get you home, I would have to
hike my shoes.
With what's that going? Rumor, kids again.
Sit down. Please, what's happening?
Please, I'm gonna...
Hi, Scotty boy.
Hi. Where you going? We'll give you a lift.
No, thanks. I'm just going up the corner.
Well, we're going that way? Fine. Come on, hop in. We'll take you where you're going.
Thanks, anyway, but I'd
I'd just soon get the exercise.
Come on, we're going that way. We'll give you a lift.
Okay, but I'm just going up to the park.
You know, you're the funniest guy I ever met in my life. Come on, hop in.
Repeat what I already told you. I had nothing to do with it. Look, Charlie, would you go to the cops if you had liquor on your breath? Don't be silly.
Okay. We'll go in the house and we'll discuss it then, huh? Come on.
Let's go.
Look, I was there. I don't think there's anything more to discuss. You guys don't want to believe me, you're just not going to believe me. That's all there is to it.
You guys messed the place up.
I thought you said your folks are going to work the weekend.
What difference does that make? I don't want the place messed up anyway.
Look, I don't know what else I can tell you, Charlie. What can I say to make you believe me? Can I try to appeal your common sense? Why would I go to the cops if I had liquor all over my breath? Don't be silly.
Look, why would I go to the cops with liquor all over me?
Okay, if that's what you say, I believe you.
Charlie, what are you doing?
Jay, get me a bottle of your old man's booze.
Hey, Charlie, my old man finds a bottle of his booze gone, he'll kill me.
If you don't find one gone, I'll kill you. Now get a bottle and a couple of glasses.
I'm sorry about all this, Charlie.
It's okay. I mean, you know. We were wrong. We just wanted to find out. You can understand that. We'll have a drink on it, huh?
Oh, man's gonna flip.
I guess it probably did look kind of funny.
Have a drink, dude, huh? Don't hurt you.
See with that stuff, Charlie. I'm not much of a drinker, man.
I think you need it. I mean, after all, we must have shook you up pretty bad.
No, thanks, Johnny. I think I've had enough.
You better drink it, or Eddie isn't going to believe you. Right, Eddie?
Yeah. Yeah, go ahead and drink it. It's good booze. Real good booze. Jay's old man never buys anything but the best.
We didn't drink a toast anything. Then we ought to drink a toast to your girlfriend. That's it. A toast to your girlfriend, huh? Now, come on, finish it.
I'm getting dizzy.
Come on, finish it. Come on.
Mm-hmm. This has gone far enough. I'm getting out of here.
How are you going to do that, happy boy? Now take that glass and drink it.
Big drinker like you ain't gonna quit now, huh? Come on. What are we gonna do with him, Charlie?
Why don't you relax? I don't know nothing now. Just relax and wait, will you?
Why don't we cut him up and leave him in the countryside somewhere, huh? How long are we gonna mess with this guy?
We're not gonna mess with him much longer. We're just about out of gas.
Okay, so get some gas. Look, it's early. We got all day.
Worth of cheap.
Well, where's the cat?
In there. Sometimes I think those guys are crazy. My old man's gonna kill me.
This place is a cinch. Look, why don't you go outside and keep this guy busy, and I'll take that hotel. He'll never know until we're gone. It's a cinch. Okay, but if there's any trouble, forget it.
Hey, I think we might need a new tire. You want to check it?
Yeah.
Sit down.
Hey, what's the matter? You want him to get sick in the car? Let him out. Come on, let him out.
trouble. We never should have left him there.
I ought to be getting the ball.
Look, shut up, will you? We're all in this together. Now, just shut up.
I don't like this. You might have killed that guy.
Look, we got to do something about this, Scotty. He's going to turn us insured. Suppose he got caught there. Then we're really in for it. What are you going to do, Charlie?
Just shut up.
Now, let me think.
Supposing you kill that guy, then what are we going to do?
Look, in the first place, I didn't hit him that hard. Chances are he got away and he's on his way home right now. Nobody ever goes by that dump of a station. Scotty does go home, he's not going to say a darn thing. He's got the money. That puts him just as deep as we are in it. Look, if we get in a jam, we put it up on him. He was drunk. The guy saw that. Now, let me think. Does get home, we got no problems at all. I know just how to stop him. Give me a gun.
Come on, hurry
up. All right, relax. Listen, Scotty asked me to call you.
He wants me to pick you up. I know you're kind of mad about last night, but well, he's in kind of a jam.
What's happened?
Well, he's over at Jay's house. He's hurt and wants to see you right now, and he doesn't want his folks to know.
I'll come by and pick you up right now, okay?
Well, what's happened to him?
He's going to be all right. I'll tell you about it when I see you.
Look, I'll pick you up in 5 minutes, so be ready.
Well...
Relax now, honey. He's inside. Okay? Sit down. We'll get him for you.
Well, where's Scotty?
Well, if you sit down, I'll get him. Jay, why don't you fix me a drink? Look, you better make yourself comfortable. We might have a long wait. Huh?
Where are you going?
I'm going to hurt you. Relax, honey.
Chicken, I think you owe us some money.
Well, you're a lot smarter than I thought you were.
Now get out of here. And you can tell your buddy Charlie that he doesn't have to worry about me telling anybody anything about what happened this afternoon. Just so long as I don't ever have to set eyes on his ugly face again. Now get out of here.
No, you're pretty smart. Because if you'd done anything else, I'm afraid your little sweetie would have been in for a lot of trouble.
What are you talking about? What happened to Jan?
You've been fooling around with kids too long. That's what's the matter. Come on. I'm not going to hurt you. Don't be scared.
No.
Just give me a little smile. That's all, Charlie.
No.
Just a smile. Come on.
No. No.
Eddie. Jay, that must be Eddie. Let him in.
Hands off of her.
Well, it isn't Dream Boy himself. You know, I knew you wouldn't go screaming to the cops. I knew it. I told Eddie right along, but that Eddie, well, you can't tell him anything now. Got a nice girl there. You're lucky to have a girl like that. It's exactly what I've been telling you. Well, that's very tender, very tender.
Shut up!
This is one story. Who's to blame? The answers are not easy, nor are they pleasant. We are all responsible. And it's our responsibility not to look the other way. Violence and immorality like this must be controlled, channeled. Citizens everywhere must work against delinquency, just as they work against cancer, cerebral palsy, or any other crippling disease. For delinquency is a disease. But the remedies are available. patience, compassion, understanding, and respect for parental and civil authority. By working with your church group, with a youth organization in your town, by paying closer attention to the needs of your children, you can help prevent the recurrence of regrettable events like the ones you have just witnessed. You can help halt this disease before it cripples our children, before it cripples society.